Okay.
Back to motherboard number one. Over there. This is motherboard number two with the documented issues. NVMe has moved over. The SATA drives have plugged in. Still have memory. This is the memory right here. It was plugged into these spots. The exact same position on this board that were on that board. And the two that were suspect are right there. So, proceeding to make sure power's off. Power button. Chassis ground. And start with this one right here, going into this position right there. Start with 16. Plugged in. Still have two power headers plugged in. So we've got that one. VRM CPU power headers plugged in, fan and water pump, Corsair, audio header USB 3, USB 2 plugged into the right side one, and audio header, haven't even tested that to see, make sure audio header works in the back. Network card is plugged in. I might get interrupted by a person coming over, so and plugged in there. First power cycle. Okay, this will keep it over. Boop, and we gotta plug in the HDMI. Probably booting the OS right now. Okay. BIOS has decided to reset itself. We are on F3G. Oops. Memory 224 out of 244. 16 gigs F2 position. It's currently, bring the mouse over. As you can see, it's in position 2 as visually inspected there. Okay, F2. Go over to get rid of that. Frequency settings, auto, that, advance, oh yeah, can turn that back to auto, and then go down to here, profile 1, clock down to 2133, manual, was messing around with latency, put this back to auto. So it's 1577735 has on the qualified vendor list. Voltages 1.23 is what I had this guy at, 1.23. And check the fan settings for the pump. Pump is at full. Don't quit without save F10. Save and exit. Double check. Delete F2 still there. Oops, and oh, it resulted to turning this back on. Sometimes turning CMS, don't need any legacy stuff. Chipset. Save and exit. One last reboot. hopefully get in. Okay, 16. And we'll go straight into here. And do an edit. Oops. Disable the PCI power management workaround. F10. Memory cable is plugged in. Backup PS2 keyboard plug in using the wireless USB from the header to the board, which worked. It's working. The message. And guess what? Look! PCI Airbus severity corrected, blah blah blah. This board with the workaround disabled shows this message. So I'm going to reboot real quick and leave it. Just blow right through and leave the PCIe advanced power management thing disabled. Tree huggers will be angry that I disabled that power management for the PCI bus. Now, log in. And that's just with one module in position 2. E message. So now that I've got the workaround to disable the power management, those messages don't show up. LS Topo. It's a NUMA mode with 16 gigs on one side, nothing on the other side. Exactly as it's physically laid out on the system. LSMEM, it recognizes 16, nothing offline, everything's online. Power off. Power switch. Just charge the capacitor, push the power button. Still light, it went out. Finally, okay. So now I'm going to install 2 and 4. That's good. Power on. Where's the BIOS A? It says 2133 for the memory, roughly 3.5 for the CPU, and the memory is above the 1.2. And it recognizes 32, and F2 it says 2 and 4. Let's see it right here. And go in. Boot the operating system. Let's look at the actual layout, which die it's supposedly going to, because the Threadripper is 2 dies with 2 different memory controllers and an inner fabric which communicates the hardware on one side with the other hardware on the other side. It's like having 2 Ryzen 7s plugged into the same physical device. Because I have the workaround turned on, I'm not getting the messages about PCI. But I am getting issues about link up, link down. That's not a good sign. LS Topo. D message 32 on one side, nothing on the other. That's exactly what it should be. Power off. Switch, discharge the caps until the lights go out. The lights are out. I'm going to install two more modules into 6 and 8. The 2, 4, 6, 8, according to the motherboard manual, power. Which is built too soon. Memory recognizes 64, which it should. The voltage is slightly above 1.2. And F2 recognizes 2, 4, 6, 8 here. Get to the boot menu. Let's check out its NUMA layout. With the PCI power management feature disabled to get rid of the messages in the system log. Message, and now it's decided to drop down 100. Not saying that it couldn't possibly be a cable issue. It could be a cable issue. I'm not focusing on the network card. If worse, I could plug in a network card into the PCI bus if that's an issue. Heater just went on. Sorry about the background noise. LS Topo. And I don't see any NUMA nodes. It says 64 in unified memory access mode. Message. LSMEM. And we're getting 66 gigabytes out of 64 on both boards. Acting strange. Next memory configuration. Power switch. Charge the capacitors by hitting the power button. Okay. Next, let's put the same 64 gig memory configuration. According to PDF, 2, 3, 4, skip 5, 6, 7, 8. Clip is open. This is the same memory configuration in the same slots as they were on the previous motherboard number 2. So next, power it on, power button, this was the only board that I've been able to actually get it to recognize 96 out of 96 sometimes, so we'll see if we get 96 gigabytes. Have not been able to get this board to recognize 128 out of 128, delete. And look, hey, we've got 96 out of 96. This board actually recognized 96. This board number 2 doesn't. So let's just go in here real quick. F2, we see 2, 3, 4, skip 5, 6, 7, 8. Exactly as what we see visually in the video here. Camera's not exactly, can't get everything. So maybe a little closer in. Sorry for all this, but Gigabyte is forcing me to document how crappy their hardware is. Maybe they'll reach out to me and actually work with me with a higher tier support, because I would love to be able to finish this whole series and say, hey, Gigabyte was great after I got past their tier 1 support. You know, things started rolling. That being said, I don't know. That fan is not actually plugged into the right position. Not critical. Not a big issue. Just unplug it. The memory is quite cold to the touch, actually. Surprisingly cold, actually. It is not being clocked high. I'm going to go into here. Oops. And boot to the offering system. With a boot to the head, anybody recognizes that reference, leave a comment. So now, enter. LSMEM says 98 gigabytes. A little surprising, not 96 LSTOPO, but it shows 47 because it rounds it down every slice. But sees 48 gigs here, 48 gigs here connected to each of the die fabrics in the CPU here. I put all four in. It goes back to 32 gigs or maybe 64. But that being said, D-message, this is the most stable system I can get with the most memory, 96. Can't get 96 on that board whatsoever. And we still have the suspect memory right here, just out of view, sorry. But I'll put them in next go around. But we're having the gig link going up and down, but not a good sign. Probably have to. It's probably a cable issue. I'm hoping it's a cable issue. One last. Power off. And then I'll have to answer the door because someone's at the door. Capacitor discharge. One last go around. That's good. High pressure.
I need you to be quiet.
Yes. This will be video number 4 in the series. So, finally got all 4 plugged in. Powered on. Taking a little longer to come up than it should, and it did a restart there. Okay. And it recognizes 32. Yet if I push F2, look, all 8 positions are filled. And doesn't matter if I go into the BIOS and make any changes, it just will only recognize 32, sometimes 64, and the BIOS, excuse me, the operating system won't show the same information. So last but not least, we'll just show the actual NUMA or lack thereof. Topography. And I'll end the recording and upload this as number 4. LSMEM, 32 gigs online, LSTOPO. It recognizes right here 32 gigs, even though there's 64 on this side, doesn't recognize anything on this side because on the node 0. Go back over to D-message, and strangely, I'm not getting any network card issues. So, like I said, memory, just a bunch of weird anomalies. And I'm just a reminder, I have to disable the power management in the kernel bootloader to disable power management on PCI bus to get rid of those error messages on this board, but don't have to do it on motherboard number two sitting over here. So because I'm getting different symptoms on two different boards, both boards could still be bad, the BIOS could still have issues, there could still be issues with the CPU. Don't think the memory's bad because I've gone through the process of testing one memory at a time using the MEM test, which does take a while. I've done it a couple modules at one, and then I did a couple modules at two, then I went through the process of testing two, and I went across the testing four 64 gigs in different configurations, so I had different permutations into the system. The memory all acts the same regardless of which modules in what position and what configuration. So I'm going to finish this, do a power off, and finish up loading this video.